They tied the knot after just 12 weeks of dating in September at the New York City courthouse. And Hailey Baldwin, 22, and Justin Bieber, 24, told Vogue that they abstained from having sex until they were man and wife, as they appear in an intimate spread in the publication, shot by acclaimed photographer Annie Leibovitz. The couple said celibacy was one of the best decisions they ever made, but admitted that marriage was always going to be hard and added that it is not a magical fantasy. Justin said his first interview in 2 years, that his religious beliefs led him to decide to abstain from being intimate with Hailey after the pop star said he had previously had a legitimate problem with sex. The singer was famously seen sneaking out of a brothel in Brazil covered in white bedsheets by his minders, back in 2013. The What Do You Mean hitmaker revealed that in June of 2018 he had been celibate already for more than a year. The singer was likely celibate during part of his relationship with Selena Gomez, 26, as it only ended that spring. He explained, "God doesn't ask us not to have sex for him because he wants rules and stuff. He's like, I'm trying to protect you from hurt and pain. I think sex can cause a lot of pain. Sometimes people have sex because they don't feel good enough. Because they lack self-worth. Women do that, and guys do that. I wanted to rededicate myself to God in that way because I really felt it was better for the condition of my soul. And I believe that God blessed me with Hailey as a result. There are perks. You get rewarded for good behavior." He admits that wanting to have sex was part of the reason they got married so quickly. But not all of it. Justin said, "When I saw her last June, I just forgot how much I loved her and how much I missed her and how much of a positive impact she made on my life. I was like, holy cow, this is what I've been looking for." Despite Justin's views on God, he says his opinions on religion can be confusing to some people. He said, "I wouldn't consider myself religious. That confuses a lot of people because they're like, well, you go to church. I believe in the story of Jesus, that's the simplicity of what I believe. But I don't believe in all the religious elitism and pretentiousness. I get sensitive when religion comes up because it's been so hurtful to a lot of people. I don't want to be thought of as someone who stands for any of the injustice that religion has done and does do." The pair first met back in 2009, but eyebrows were raised when Justin rekindled his romance with Hailey 3 years ago. They had ran into each other at a conference in Miami hosted by Rich Wilkerson Jr., the pastor of VU Church, who officiated Kim and Kanye's wedding. It was just 6 months after he split from singer Selena Gomez, 26, his on-off girlfriend since 2010. Hailey said they were past the drama of their previous romance by then, and Justin told her, "We're not going to be friends with plans for them to be a proper couple." She said she never thought of Justin as more than anything other than a crush, as they had a weird age difference when they first met. One day, she said, Justin walked into Hillsong and was like, "Hey, you got older." I was like, "Yeah, what's up?" Over time he became my best guy friend. I was running around with him as his homie, but we weren't hanging out, romantically. When things had got romantic between them 3 years ago, Hailey admits they were in a very toxic relationship and hints that there was a betrayal. The model admitted that Justin was in a dark place with his career and personal life, which affected them immensely. She said, "Negative things happened that we still need to talk about and work through. Fizzled would not be the right word, it was more like a very dramatic excommunication. There was a period where if I walked into a room, he would walk out." Justin told the publication, "It's been so hard for me to trust people. I've struggled with the feeling that people are using me or aren't really there for me. One of the big things for me is trusting myself." Adding, "I'm the emotionally unstable one. I struggle with finding peace. I just feel like I care so much and I want things to be so good and I want people to like me. Hailey's very logical and structured, which I need. I've always wanted security, with my dad being gone sometimes when I was a kid, with being on the road." Justin revealed he had to step back a bit as he had become arrogant and cocky, with Hailey revealing he was wearing sunglasses in the house at night. He said, "I found myself doing things that I was so ashamed of, being super promiscuous and stuff, and I think I used Xanax because I was so ashamed. Justin said his security had to come in his room and check his pulse each night when things got particularly dark. Haley, on the other hand, has never touched a drug, convinced of her genetic vulnerability to addiction. Her father Stephen had a severe problem with cocaine before she was born and has been sober for nearly 30 years, and she trained as a ballerina for 12 years. Justin said he wishes that Haley would take just a little pressure off herself as a new wife, saying, "She's trying to be this grown-up. I think we can be married and still have fun and enjoy our adolescence. That's something we're talking about." The pretty blonde said she is navigating her way through being a newlywed in the best way she can. She said, "It's just that I'm fighting to do this the right way, to build a healthy relationship. I want people to know that. We're coming from a really genuine place. But we're two young people who are learning as we go. I'm not going to sit here and lie and say it's all a magical fantasy. It's always going to be hard." That is the sentence you should lead with. It's really effing hard. We are really young, and that's a scary aspect. We're going to change a lot. But we're committed to growing together and supporting each other in those changes. That's how I look at it. At the end of the day, too, he's my best friend. I never get sick of him. Justin grins. "And you're my baby boo." Haley admits that the first weeks of marriage were deeply lonely for her because she was homesick for her parents, even though she hadn't lived with them in 5 years. She also felt like people on social media were keen for them to fail, and Haley said that no one appreciated how seriously she had taken the decision to marry. She said, "I love him very much. I have loved him for a long time." Justin and Haley tied the knot in a secret courthouse ceremony in New York City in September and have bought a house in Toronto. The couple exchanged vows on the same day they obtained their marriage license and are not believed to have had a prenuptial agreement in place. A source claimed Justin is so in love and doesn't see the need for one. The superstar pair had a preacher on hand, Jeffrey Quinn, a member of the faculty at Nyack College near the courthouse, while Justin's friend Josh Mell was the witness at the ceremony. The couple are still said to be planning a formal ceremony, but it will be simply symbolic now they are officially husband and wife. The couple got engaged on July 7 in the Bahamas and previously dated off and on between 2015 and 2016. In a recent interview with Coveter magazine, Haley called her engagement to Justin the biggest OMG moment of her life. She enthused, "I got engaged. I think that's probably the biggest OMG moment of the year for me, of my life. So that's probably top."